Dream big, work hard, and surround yourself with good people. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's episode of 7 Good Minutes, our friend Dre Baldwin talks with us about the importance of surrounding yourself with good people. Enjoy.
I want to talk to you about the 3 types of people that you want to have around you in your life when it comes to your personal and your professional development. So that personal professional development, for those who don't know what that means, that's what you're doing, what your strategy is, your long-term strategy and short-term for getting smarter, becoming better at what you do, making yourself more valuable, just having more game and being more efficient at bringing that game into the world so that you can get the ROI for your game. So for example, if you're a really good salesperson, you want people to know that you're a good salesperson. Or if you're really good at doing whatever job, XYZ job, you want it to be known that you're good at that job. So just being good by itself is not enough. You want to be efficient at getting your goodness out into the world so that you can get paid properly in exchange for the game that you bring to the world. So all of that goes under this umbrella that we call personal and professional development. But anyway, when it comes to your personal and professional development, there are 3 people that you want to keep around you at all times. I'm going to explain to you who those 3 people are and why you want them around you. First of all, you want a person around you who is doing a lot better than you. These are people who are 10 levels above you in whatever area. They don't have to be in your same industry. They can just be 10 levels above you. Maybe they're just a lot smarter than you. Maybe they have a lot more experience than you. Maybe they just made a lot more money than you. Maybe they just know a lot more people than you know. But for whatever reason, by whatever measure that you're looking at, they are just way, way above you. They're where you want to be. If everything works out for you and you do everything you need to do, 10 years from now, you'll be where they are. You need people around you who are like this. And these people can be around you in the form of, hey, maybe your parents are these people. But if they're not, then maybe those people might be mentors. They could become your coaches, people that you can hire. They can be your virtual mentors, meaning you don't even know this person, never even met them before, but because you follow all their material, you read their books, you watch them on YouTube, you listen to their podcasts, you take their courses, whatever it is, you can learn from them. These are people who are way above you, have been there and done that, everything that you're trying to do, they've already achieved it, at least again in some area, and you're just trying to soak up that game. So this is like in professional sports, you know, you got the athlete who's just coming into the league, they're a rookie, then you got the 10-year veteran who's already been there and done everything that rookie's going to go through. And the veteran kind of mentors the rookie. So every time the rookie makes a mistake, lets them know, like, yo, here's where you messed up. Or here's what you need to do off the court. Here's how you take care of your body. Here's what you should do with your money. And the same thing happens in the business world. Same thing happens just in everyday life. You need to have people around you, at least one person around you. I said 3 different people to have around you, but it doesn't have to be just one person. You can have 10 of these people around you. But you need mentors, people who have been there and done that for whatever you're trying to get to. And let me also make clear, you can have these people for different aspects of life. So for example, if you play sports, you might have a mentor for getting better at your sport. Like you play football, so you got somebody who already did everything in football who can mentor you on what's coming up in football. But at the same time, you want somebody who can help you with your money. You might have somebody who doesn't play football, but they understand money. So they can help you on the money side of things. Then maybe you're in a relationship and you have kids, and you need someone who can help you with the kids and relationships side of things. That could be another person that's 10 levels above you because they got a family and they have kids and they can mentor you on that. So you want people who are 10 levels above you in every aspect of life that matters to you, who've already been where you're trying to get to. And it could be more than one person for different areas, or maybe you meet some people who are dynamic and they can help you with multiple areas at the same time. Those people can become your personal coaches, again, mentors, etc. So that's the first type of person you need. The second type of person you need around you is the person who is on your level, but not doing exactly the same as you. This is a person who is your rookie in the sport, they're a rookie as well. All right, you run a business, your business is around 100K a year. All right, they got a business that's around 100K a year. Or maybe they just went a little bit up, or maybe they're on their way, they're almost there. These are the people that are and they're on the same road that you're on. They're dealing with the same stuff that you're dealing with. So the same challenges that you're having every day, they're having them. The same problems you're running into, they got them. The same things that you need to do next, the same next steps that you need to take, they need to take those same next steps. The reason why you want these people around you is because these are individuals with whom you can bounce ideas off of. You can say, all right, well, look, I'm dealing with this problem with my staff, or this problem in my career, or this is what's going on in my relationship, or this is what's going on, you know, with, you know, me and my business partners. They got the same problems, and they might have a different way of approaching it than what you did. So you dealt with it this way, but they're like, well, look, this is what I did. So you might take that idea and maybe take a little bit of what they did, use it in what you're doing, and you can help them, they can help you. And sometimes we call this, well, actually what we call it is masterminding. What a mastermind is when two or more people come together in a spirit of harmony and they share both of their minds. So I share what I know, you share what you know, and because both of us are sharing our own minds, that's 1 + 1, we create a third mind. The third mind is the mastermind, because us two together creates a separate entity other than just me by myself, you by yourself. So this is why you want to have people around you who are doing similar to you, but different from you. So you could be a football player. You might mastermind with somebody who's a basketball player, or you might be in the e-commerce industry where the business is doing $500,000 a year. You might mastermind with somebody who's in the education industry and they do about $500,000 a year. Or you might have somebody who's in, you know, network marketing doing the same amount, or someone who sells cars, or someone who is a franchisee and they do the same. They're making around the same amount of money as you, or they're at a similar level to you, but they do things a little bit different from you, so that y'all can bounce ideas off of each other. Or, well, I tried this, this worked. Or I did this, this worked for me. And now everybody can learn from everyone else. The synergy of the group makes everyone smarter and stronger. This is the concept of the mastermind. So this is why you want people around you who are similar to you, but different.
Please keep in mind, this is about half the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.